thanks for joining me, and welcome to another ASMR and beer video where I will be doing a modest little review and tasting of Pauwel. Traditional Belgian special ale out of a family brewery, Bostiels, Buchenwald, Belgium. This was a beer that was recommended by a viewer, at least one. I also have video, as well as Tank 7 Farmhouse Ale. So I just wanted to let you know that I have those beer reviews or beer tastings upcoming in fairly soon after this one, not months apart. So after I do modest little beer tasting, I'm going to be playing a little game of solitaire that hopefully you might enjoy, find relaxing, or possibly put you to sleep. And I'll be eating some dry roasted as well. I was going to do all three beers in one video, but I think they all deserve their own video, and it's a little too much to do all three in one, especially when the ABV, the alcohol by volume for each beer, is at least like 8%. So, now, I normally do not purchase beer like you see in these specialty bottles, but I wanted to just do something a little different, and it was either purchase one of these bottles, or it was purchase at least a six pack, and I don't know if all of these, if each beer had its own six pack. Some of them, I think, like this, the Kwak, may not come in a six pack, so I opted to just do splurge a little bit than usual, and pick them up in this particular style. I normally wouldn't do it just because it's a little pricey, but you know, it depends, you know, whether or not you're gonna, you know, share it, I guess, or what the case may be. So it says Anno 1791, which I'm going to assume is probably when it was established. Now I can't speak Belgian at all, but or pronounce the language, but it says Pauwel, so I'm gonna say it's like Pauwel, Kwak, I don't think it's Kwak, and then it says traditional Belgian special ale, family brewery, Bostiels, Buchenwald, I think that's how you pronounce that, Belgium, 8.4% ABV, Pauwel. established it. I don't really know the history. So it says authentic Belgian ale, product of Belgium. Pauwel, Kwak is a full-bodied Belgian specialty ale, amber in color, with beautiful foam and slightly sweet, seductive malt character. Rich, satisfying Belgian ale experience. Brewed by the Bastille's family brewers since 1791. Gold medal World Beer Cup, rated exceptional Beverage Testing Institute, gold medal European Beer Star. And so that is it. So before we do that, we're going to limber up and do our exercises. I'm a huge proponent of getting a little cardio in before we drink. So you can, you know, feel free to watch. You can join our little beer buddy. All right, so we're going to do 10 reps. We'll go easy. Normally, sometimes we do 20, but tonight we'll do 10. All right, here we go. We got 1, 2, 3, 4. You're doing great. 5, 6, 7, 8. Two more. 9, and 10. Good job. Give yourself a round of applause. All right, so let us open this. Hopefully it's not going to explode on me. I've had that happen before. Okay. And one of the best reviews from 2014, something like this. And don't worry if it okay. All right, so we lucked out. That picked up, and this is usually used for Belgian style ales, this particular glass. I mean, I'm not such a beer connoisseur. I will pour it almost in anything, this one or one of the regular craft glasses. All right, so let's give this a nice pour. these ASMR beer videos, it's not so much to give a proper review as it is to give just my humble little honest, you know, everyday guy, kind of everyday Joe, Jane, what have you. review and tasting, really. Now, it not much lacing on the head there. Of course, it could be the way I poured it, but it does have a really nice, hopefully you can pick that up, a very nice cloudy amber color. And some carbonation, but it's not too heavy, the carbonation. It's looks a little bit of carbonation, actually. So let's give this a nice smell. So I am smelling like some grapefruit, some like orange peel, some citrus. And then like so it's got that citrus fruity kind of aroma. And then I want to say it's a little more heady, I don't have the best sniffer. A little hoppy, not too much. And then a little I don't want to say grassy, but there's another layer there. These are usually complex beers, from what I understand. You know, when it comes to the taste I guess more the taste. I mean, the ingredients. Complex flavor, I guess you would say, but I guess that would lend to the aroma too. So, from me to you, cheers. Kling. It's delicious. Has a very nice, sweet citrus. It's like, I was looking on Beer Advocate, because I'm not the best when it comes to describing beers. People use all kinds of descriptions like bubblegum and pineapple and things I just wouldn't think of to describe a beer. I can definitely taste those flavors. Let me see if I can taste, you know, that bubblegum pineapple kind of. I mean, it's very it's definitely complex. it's really, really delicious. Not much of an alcohol taste for being 4%. It's a little bit, I want to say it has some spice to it. It definitely has some nice spice, not bitter. It's definitely creamy. I can feel it has a little bit of a spicy aftertaste to it, a little bit it's I'm at a loss for words here. I don't want to try to act too much like I know what I'm doing. A little creamy, with a mix of, a nice spice to it. The aftertaste has got some spice, not bitter, but more of that, not spice, like nutmeg. I want to say peppery, but not, you know, too peppery. if that makes sense. This is really good. I would definitely give this, this is really good. I'll give this 4 stars. With the taste. And, you know, on the higher end, like 3.8 stars, you know, 4. Some folks say it finishes dry. And, I mean, I would say that. I just want to kind of ramble a little bit before I get into the solitaire. And I just kind of want to say a couple things. First off, Teacher Appreciation Week. National Teacher Appreciation Week here in the United States. Apparently is celebrated around the first week of May. So definitely, I want to raise my glass to all the teachers out there. I want to try to do a video just to help teachers relax. And as kids, we always, you know, it's just interesting to go full circle from being a kid to now being a parent and having a kid. It's just, you know, I know there are teachers that, some teachers are really good, they really care about the kids, and then there's, you know, some teachers that may not, you know, be the best, but maybe they started out, maybe they got jaded, I don't know, but for those teachers whose heart, you know, who are really there to help, you know, they deserve our respect, and it's not cool at all for kids to disrespect the teachers, you know, even those teachers that may not be, I don't know, I don't want to start judging teachers, the types of teachers, but, you know, they're people too. They were kids once. You know, we were all kids once and children once, and then we all have our personal lives. We're all trying to do the best with our lives, and the teachers are really trying to help the kids, and you know, I'm talking more about elementary and high school. I never went to college, so I can't speak there. But I know there's teachers out there who get a hard time from kids, and that's not cool, you know? And no, I don't want to just defend every teacher outright, because I'm sure there are some teachers out there who have done some questionable things, all right? But, you know, for the teachers that, you know, don't deserve to be harassed by kids and all that, you know, it's, and while I have my complaints and issues with the educational system here in the United States in regards to what we're teaching kids, what we're not teaching kids, things like that, the teachers, they're trying to do their best to help these kids, to help children in the system that we have. This is the system that we have, whether we like it or not. I don't necessarily agree with the type of government that we have or the educational system, but we don't have another choice. I don't know what other system might or might not work besides the ones that we have. We definitely shouldn't. I'm starting to get off political here. Teachers, thank you. From me, you know, thank you for putting up with a lot of the kids. Some of the, you know, the bad apples, they come from homes that might, you know, maybe broken homes, whatever their case may be. Every kid has a story. And for those kids out there, respect your teachers and all that, you know. I can't help but come across like a dad sometimes. That's a part of who I am. Right now, I'm trying not to be so much a dad, but just a regular guy. But, you know, just more compassion, more empathy for teachers, for students, and for a system that I think needs to be improved. And, you know, we just need to progress, to continue to progress, and not to become complacent with the systems that we have. You know, that's... So, thanks, teachers. And aside from that, I'm going to, you know, I like to, like I said, I'm going to do a traditional ASMR video dedicated for the teachers out there, because really, you are one of the unsung heroes. Now, the other thing I want to talk about briefly before I get into the solitaire, I mean, this is delicious beer, by the way, really. So thank you for those folks, by the way, that suggested the beers that you did. Now, and those of you who suggested that I didn't get a chance to pick or choose, I can only do so many beer reviews and whatnot. Anyway, so the prior video to this, the Nature Journey number 25, I got a chance to get out Sunday morning, April 17th, and enjoy a nice walk slash hike, walk about through French Creek State Park, which I've never been to before, which was great. And I just want to say that I can't, throughout the course of this channel, I can't encourage enough or suggest enough, stress enough that you get outside and try to enjoy nature as much as possible, because it is therapeutic for the mind. It really is. It's like a big reset button for me personally. It's like it's a way to get it from, you know, not just to get away from the hustle and bustle, but it just kind of, it's like coming back to I don't want to say like the beginning, but it's like a reset. I go out there, it's serene for the most part, and you get some exercise, of course, and there's something to be said about the color green. I've said that a lot of times throughout different videos, or nature videos especially. And, you know, it's not for everyone. I know that. Not everyone likes the outdoors, and a lot of people don't like the bugs. You know, I can dig it. But just to get outside it and do something, some kind of activity, exercise is just so very important. But I personally would just suggest, you know, exercising out in nature, a nice walk in a park, beach, whatever it might be, because it's just so beneficial. And I'm also a huge proponent of nature. I mean, we wouldn't be here if the whole world was nothing but cement and buildings. We wouldn't be here. And it's, I don't want to get too political again. It's, but, it's, it's kind of hypocritical how we've destroyed a lot of the earth just so we can have houses, water, power, nuclear. You know, we've created dams. It just, you know, I don't, like I said, I don't like to, I don't mean to get political. I'm not trying to throw a guilt trip, but this is just my truth. This is how I see things, my subjective view. So. All right, well, I think it's time to flip the camera facing down. I'm going to lay out the cards, and we're going to enjoy a little solitaire. I hope you enjoy it. And again, thanks for joining me. I will see you in another video real soon. Said we don't have the microphone placed properly near the camera, but all right, and then just grab a napkin here. that. So I'm just gonna solitaire yourself from time to time. It's quite relaxing just to pass the time. Up here. And we reveal a four of clubs. So let's say we can put the four here. And we reveal a nine of spades. Nine of spades can go. So what we're doing here with the solitaire, just in case you aren't familiar with the game, opposite cards, opposite colors, go in descending order here in the, I'm not sure what you call this, in the, oh, there's a joker in here. That was brilliant. I forgot to take that out. Now I'm not sure if I have a whole 52 deck or not. Purposes anyway. Ain't that big of a deal. Alright. So, you start from the top down, but you can always move the numbered card to a higher numbered card of opposite color. Up top here, you will have the four suits, starting from the ace. Is almost like a one in this case, counted as the number one. So let's see what we have here. We have a red eight. We can go can't do anything with a nine of clubs. So far. I wonder how many folks still play this in today's world. Aside from maybe, you know, older folks like yours truly, or older. But, that's gonna... Oh, we got the four clubs here. No, I'm looking for a five of clubs, five of diamonds. Oh, five of diamonds right here. That's what happens when you drink a beer and try to play a game that requires using your brain, especially after a long day of work. Spades, can't do anything with that. I think that's it. Okay. One, two, three. Six of hearts. Well, I can move that here into the seven of spades. Then we can move the black five of spades here. Okay, so far. It's probably one of the best hands that I've ever played in a video. Spades up top. noticed that before. We're doing pretty well, actually. Don't have a 7 of clubs, don't have a 6 of diamonds. 4 of spades here, but I can't get to it till I get out. There's the 2 of hearts. 3 of hearts. 9. Here. 8. Here, so 10. 9. 8. Seven. Trapped right now, stuck. 1, 2, 3, 7 of hearts. Can't do anything with that. And then 1, 2, jack of spades. So it's gonna repeat itself. 1, 2, 3. I keep going back, so I'm done. Let's see if that 4 of hearts. Oh, am I missing a 4 of hearts? So I'm already gimped because I don't have a 4 of hearts. I'm already missing cards from my deck. This is great. I have this other deck, but I'm missing 1 card. Yeah, this is great. Great way to play a game of solitaire, right? Missing a card. Oh, maybe it's under here. Yep, nope. No 4 of hearts. This is brilliant. What the heck is it? That's what happens when the professor starts messing with all my stuff. Alright, anyway. Well, this has been quite a game. At least, oh, wait, there's one more card. There it is, 4 of hearts. I didn't know there was another one under there. Okay. challenge. It's too late anyway to go looking for two cards that I don't have no idea where they are. With all the props that I have, one of these days I need to do a prop video. Okay, let's cut this deck. Spades. Can't do it. Seven of spades. Can't do anything with that. One, two, three. And jack of clubs. Can't do anything with that. One, two, three. Five of spades. One, two, three. Jack of spades. One, two. That's all that's left. And then we're just going to repeat ourselves. I think we're done here. This was a quick game. I'm not really capable of doing much here. I moved some cards around, but I'm pretty much done. One, two, three. Seven of spades. Can't do anything with that. One, two, three. Jack of clubs. One, two, three. Five of spades. Jack, one, jack of spades, one, two, and king. So, that's it. I'm done. Can't do anything. So, well, that's gonna do it. So, I hope you enjoyed this beer review, or beer tasting. It's not so much a review, but, you know. Hopefully you enjoy that beer. Hopefully you enjoyed this little game. Hopefully you enjoyed the whole video. Hopefully you're asleep right now and don't even hear a word that I'm saying. Because that's what I like to hear. Or that's what I don't like to hear. If you're sleeping, I wouldn't hear you. Yeah, so. Alright, so. Now you take care of yourself and see you in another video real soon.